If you're watching this video, you're probably interested in, is note-taking important? My name's Jonathan Kemp, I'm a human intelligence entrepreneur and creator of SmartWisdom, the scientifically proven next generation note-taking and planning technique. I've been helping experienced professionals, mainly in the City of London, to help them to manage knowledge more effectively and to manage information more effectively in their day-to-day work. So, is note-taking important? I believe note-taking is probably one of the most important life skills we actually have. Which is quite a strong statement, and I'll explain why. And I can explain by just switching two words. Let's replace notes with the word knowledge, because that's what it is. Now, if I say, is managing knowledge an important skill? That changes everything, because my ability to manage knowledge when I'm in education determines where I go next, what university, what career. That can literally determine my life. How I manage knowledge in the workplace can determine the amount of value I give other people. It determines my level of professionalism. It determines whether I spot opportunities that other people aren't spotting, which can add huge value both for myself and the people I'm working with. Or alternatively, am I missing things? Now, I come from a position, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to share actually a better way of managing knowledge than you might have seen otherwise, which quite literally transforms everything. Because right now, the only options we've got is we can sit and listen, but that's not very effective. Or we can take notes, but is that skill important? I think it's much more important than sitting and listening. However, everyone, if they take notes, are using what I call a previous generation note-taking technique, developed 2,000 years ago, has not changed. It's basically record now to use later. And I did this for years. And, you know, I found note-taking boring. Often I'd switch off. It was tiring on the hand, but more importantly, I felt sometimes, and in fact quite often, the more I wrote, the more it restricted my understanding. So the temptation was always to listen, and listening's hopeless because the short-term memory, and we forget most of what we, you know, what we were listening to within 48 hours. So I'm going to share with you my journey from, you know, the frustrations of previous generation note-taking to creating the next generation note-taking technique, which actually empowers me. It enables me to do things that other people cannot, and it gives me a really clear competitive edge. It's really easy to do, and you can start adopting these skills within less than a day. So here is an example of previous generation note-taking. Note-taking is without a doubt a critical skill for all humans. The reasons it improves our understanding and increases our capabilities. So how I increased the importance of note-taking, the first step, there are four key steps. The first one is deep filtering. So here we go. I'd keep the word note-taking. I don't need is without doubt, because actually that's going to be captured by the word critical. Next, skill. Humans. Here are the reasons, so I don't need that. I'd go improves understanding and increases capabilities. So already one of the things that happens with the deep filtering, I straight away start to increase some of my cognitive capabilities. So I increase my ability to focus and concentrate, and I can hold this for an hour easily. Using previous generation note-taking, no. Sitting, listening, not a chance. The next secret is deep processing. And it's really easy once you get the hang of it. So I'm going to do a lot of abbreviations. It just helps to speed up the process. And this is what I do in reality. So note-taking. It's a critical skill for humans. Now, the word and is a magical word, because as soon as I hit and or, I know I'm going to start chunking information. So humans, it improves understanding, which sounds, you know, sort of important, but is actually crucial. And it increases our capabilities. Okay, capabilities. Now, this alone is a game changer. I mean, it's a strong word, game changer, but I would use that word, game changer. It makes a difference between night and day, and I'll explain why. Because there are about three key percentages you want to be looking for when you're managing knowledge, and one of them is your percentage RTU. So whatever strategy you're using, what is the percentage RTU? And the percentage is real-time understanding. Now, cognitive neuroscientists have assessed these types of methodologies, you know, writing sentences or bullets, and they found real-time understanding was about 64%, which is sort of all right, but it's not great. Within 2 weeks of switching to deep filtering and deep processing, your real-time understanding goes up to 76%, and within a year up to 84%. And if you're dyslexic, the good news is you get even more of a competitive edge actually over non-dyslexics. Your real-time understanding goes up to 87% beyond what everyone else is doing. Now, this changes everything, because this means I'm able to manage knowledge at a much better level. I can go into presentations where I've got no prior knowledge, get up to speed really quickly, ask questions, spot links, have ideas that literally no one else is having, because they're either listening or using previous generation note-taking. The second key measurement when managing knowledge, I'll use a different pen so it's a bit clearer, is percentage GA, which is glance access. Because the more you can put knowledge externally and actually see it as you're talking to someone, in effect, what you're doing is you're extending your short-term memory way beyond what a listener can achieve or a previous generation note taker. Now, myself personally, I find this much easier to look at a glance than that. And in fact, I can look at an hour's worth of that. So here is an hour's meeting. I can see this at a glance in a way that if that was written up, apart from anything else, that would be about two. The equivalent of this is about two pages. Here, I'm able to see all of this real time. And because of that, I'm able to utilize that knowledge real time. And also when I go out of the meeting or the presentation, because of the deep processing, quite often I might have to go back to, say, some knowledge maybe 6 months later, a year later. I can get back up to speed with this in about 10 seconds with about 90-95% recall. So it's all really simple, but incredibly powerful. Please feel free if you're to start adopting these techniques, because what it does, it increases the importance of note-taking as a skill. So remember, it's deep filtering, deep processing, creating categories. All of this will make a huge difference for yourself, as it did for me. If you've liked this video, please press like. Of course, feel free to comment. And if you know of anyone, you know, either as an individual or a team leader or an organization leader who's passionate about helping themselves or the people they work with to be more professional, improve their performance, increase their capabilities, and just to help everyone feel more confident when in challenging situations trying to manage knowledge, then please share this video widely. And of course, you know, if I've given you the basics of Smart Wisdom, please feel free to use that. But if you want to learn more, please do come and join me as an information athlete. Thank you very much for watching, and have a superb rest of the day. One final thing, down below, over there, or up there, you'll find a link. And I've put together some free information tips on how to manage information and knowledge more effectively. Thank you.